We help all children in the UK with any illness whatsoever. The only qualifying factor is they haven't been able to get the help elsewhere through the NHS or through other charities. So we are there to help all the most needy cases, kids with all sorts of illnesses, 600 illnesses in total. And in some of those cases, we're able to transform the lives completely. Kids with that have suffered various illnesses, we're able to get them walking again. With type 2 muscular atrophy, we provide them with a wheelchair, which doesn't get them walking, but gives them a life back. So there's so many different illnesses that we're helping with and helping to transform the lives and make the lives not only better for them, but for the parents and the siblings.
Why do you think there is such a gap between the need for support and the support that is being given by the NHS and by other government-led organisations?
Yeah, I mean, the gap between making all these kids' lives a lot better, it's a financial gap. And the NHS just can't afford. There's so many illnesses that the NHS have to fund. And when you look at some of the work we do, you'd have to say that in a Western civilization, these kids are entitled at the very, very least to what we do for them. But it's not available on the NHS because the NHS has no more money. You know, and the only way of providing this treatment for kids on the NHS would be to put people's taxation rate up to 60%, 70% and so on. And then, of course, that doesn't work for the economy of the country. So what we rely on as a nation, and so do many other nations, is the generosity of everybody in that country to donate money, and especially the wealthy who can really make a big difference. But it's down to everybody to do whatever they can do. But I think the wealthy really have a responsibility to do more. Well, it's very, very easy to find Caudwell Children on the website and to make donations. We love it when people get the heart and mind and not just the money, but that's not necessary. We need the money. We need money principally. But when people get the heart and mind into it, they really get a fantastic sense of spiritual reward for the work that they're doing. And they meet the kids and see the kids, those who they've provided a destination dreams holiday for, or who's been helped with autism, or who's been provided with a wheelchair that transforms their lives. So they can get very, very close to the work and to the children and see what difference their money makes. And that is a fantastic feeling.